Success consists of going from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. A very good afternoon to one and all. I, Muskan Jain, welcome you all for today's panel discussion with our dear alumni. We would commence the session with the recitation of National Anthem. I request everyone to please rise. I request everyone to please be seated. It's my pleasure to introduce you to our panelists for today's discussion. I would now like to introduce you to our first panelist for today's session. Ms. Rajnandi Vyas, alumnus of Batch 2013-15. Ma'am is currently working with TCS as business analyst. She has also worked with renowned organizations like UTH Beverage Factory Private Limited, New Zealand Trade and Enterprise, Seniority Limited, and FirstCry.com. She has more than 6 years of experience in the area of branding and advertisement. A heartily welcome, ma'am. Our second panelist for today's session is Mr. Zubair Sheikh, alumnus of Batch 2002-04. Sir is currently working at DB Schenker. Sir has more than 17 years of experience, wherein he has worked with DSV Global Transport and Logistics, JS Worldwide, DHL, and WordBus International. Welcome, sir. Our third panelist for today is Mr. Devesh Pratap Singh Parihar, alumnus of Batch 2005-07. Sir has 14 years of experience and is currently working with Credit Suisse. Sir has diversified experience in capital markets, custodian services, credit risk management, business analysis, and regulatory compliance in international banking. A heartily welcome, sir. Our fourth panelist for today's session is Mr. Omkar Ullas Bhagwat, alumnus of batch 2007-9. Sir has his own venture named Acute Investment, wherein he gives his service for complete financial services products, M&A, tax planning and fundraising. Sir has previously worked with BNY Mellon, HDFC Bank Mumbai and Kotak Mahindra Pune. Welcome, sir. Our fifth panelist for today's session is Mr. Rakesh Kandari, alumnus of batch 2007-9. Sir is currently working with vibrant MSME sector. Sir has more than 11 years of experience and has previously worked with John Deere, Subros, Wiston, Faurecia, Atlas Copco, Bros, 3M to name a few. We welcome you, sir. Our next panelist for today's session is Mr. Praveen Jadhav. Sir is currently working with Surfer Mills Limited, Pune, as senior manager. Sir has more than 14 years of experience, which includes PI Industry Limited, Pune, Sygentia India Limited, Rallis India Limited, and Myco Seeds Limited. Sir is also the joint secretary of Maharashtra Crop Protection Association, Pune. A heartily welcome, sir. Our next panelist for today's session is Mr. Akesh Raju, alumnus of batch 2016-18. Sir is currently working with Housing.com as senior manager. Prior to this, he was working with Info Edge India Limited as assistant manager. Welcome, sir. Now, I would request Neeraj sir to take the session further.
Good afternoon, one and all. Hello everyone, I wish each one of you a pleasant afternoon. Where is a will, there is a way. With this beautiful saying, I, Professor Neeraj Kumar Sathone, your moderator for today's session, would like to welcome you all in the alumni panel discussion for our 22nd batch of PGDM at IIBM Indus Business School, Pune. The success of an institute can be measured by the successful alumni. And I really proud of our alumni sitting here as they will discuss today on the transformational journey college to corporate. So let's begin. Before that, I would like to speak something. As all the alumni came at around 1:30, so we have a discussion, healthy discussion over in the room. So they told us most of the thing about the campus, the rigorous training provided by the campus, and they are very happy. They told me, means some alumni told me that they are punished many a times in the campus, but now today they are feeling good that time they got punished, so today they are privileged that they are means successful in their career. So instead of wasting your time, I would like to directly start this session with all the alumni, and I request each one of you to share your transformational journey. 5 to 10 minutes you can take, but tell us about the how means the college have helped you to reach to this position, and what is your message to all the students who are available here, that how they can means groom themselves in these 2 years so that they can face the future challenge after 2 years very easily. Yes sir, now I would like to take to sir first. Yes sir.
So good afternoon all, and thanks to Jai sir and IIBM Indus Institute of Business Management for giving us an opportunity to interact with all of you. It's really a pride moment for us, like after completion of your MBA course and coming back to your institute to deliver a lecture or interacting with the people. Okay, so for me it's a really proud moment, and I really appreciate what institute has done in our life previously. Due to this, what we can say, pain points, I cannot say the pain points, but due to this punctuality, discipline, and the rigorous follow-up during our 2 year sessions, that's why we have grown entirely. All of us are agree with this sentence. So I'll not take that much time for elaborating the institute's journey or something else. So basically, my name is Praveen Jadhav, and I am from very rural ground background. My native place is Phaltan, district Satara, which is nearby to Pune. I coming from a farming background, okay, middle class farming background. I done my BSc agriculture from agriculture college, Government of Agriculture College, Amravati, that's in Vidarbha. After completion of agriculture, that time agriculture and MBA, that was not a traditional combination, you can say, okay. Because we as agriculture graduate, we are looking for an opportunity towards MPSC or UPSC, something like that. We were also studying for MPSC. Unfortunately, that time some things were happen. So 2-3 years, the advertisement were not came for MPSC. So we decided to shift our career to MBA. After getting admission in IIEBM, we were almost 13, 14 people there from agriculture background. We saw this type of, what can I say, Pune's glorious, what we can say, the climate and the total environment of metros, because we were studying in rural areas and then agriculture background. So you know that how we were at our English and our approach and something like that. Okay. So during these 2 years, we have studied lots of things like personality development, how to approach the people, how to manage yourself. The prime and what we can say the foremost important thing was time management. Because in our days, now also it will be happen, in our days 8 o'clock the gate were closed. Right now also same thing is happening, I guess. Okay, so nobody was entering to after 8 o'clock. So if you wish to enter into the college, you have to give a penalty, that's it. 8 to 8 was our session, and we were in a international business plus biotechnology, and my curriculum was also triple M. So you can imagine that how much load we were have apart from the normal MBA. So after 1.5 year, everybody was getting the placement in banking, FMCG, insurance sectors, sector was that time was in the boom, retail, but agriculture companies were not here. Because of nobody was there in our alumni database, so nobody was coming into this college. And agriculture plus MBA was not a that much kind of a trendsetter in a market. So Jai sir has approached us and he told us, you get your placement at your own by having an entry in a placement cell or placement coordinator. Fortunately, we got an opportunity to represent our agriculture students to industry. So we started journey to be different kind of agriculture companies, and we used to give the brochure and prospects, our students profile and all. That time nobody was entertained us, because everybody was required ready-made material, you know, ready-made material. Nobody want fresher. Right now also same thing is happening in the market. You have to understand that thing. Nobody wants ready-made material. Even I also don't want ready-made material. I don't have time to train the people. I just want the people who can deliver from day one. That was the setting in a market. Right now also same thing is happening. So you will thinking that, so why we should there? Okay, we will also come into the first day. So I will just tell you, it will take us some 5-10 minutes time if you allow. So after that we started approaching the companies. One company, Mahiko Seeds Limited, we went over there and given an interview. That time 36 candidates were there, And out of 36, we were there. We are three people from our institute and 33 from other companies and institutes were there. Sales and marketing, precisely. The position was sales manager, sales trainee or management trainee, something like that. We didn't have any kind of experience. We just have experience of presenting ourselves in front of the people. That experience we just have. And the confidence, number one thing. So among these 36 people, three people were selected for the management trainee or sales trainee. And these three people were from IIEBM. Okay, so that was our first company. So we started the journey. I cannot say my salary at that time, but the salary what I have taken in first company, right now I'm giving 10 times of income tax per month. So that is the, I can say the very precisely. Okay, so the point is, what I just want to tell you, the point is, you have to start very, very down level. If you have a MBA, okay, you have your basic domain degree, so you have to start out down level. After that, I shifted to Rallis India Limited, the Tata group of company. Then I shifted to Syngenta India Limited, that was the number one company in agrochemical. You might be know that, right now also it's a number one. After that, I have set my goal into my mind that yes, after getting a MBA, so we have to differentiate ourselves in a crowd. Okay, there were many people who were having a 20 years of background, 30 years of background, who were sitting in the position of senior level management. And I can say one thing, growing step by step is very important. If you get a position directly top management in something like the agriculture company or any kind of company, will fall down immediately. That is the truth story. That is a practical thing. Okay, so after that 5 years, I shifted to Syngenta India Limited. I work over there for 5 years in a core, hardcore sales profile for agrochemical. And after that, I got an opportunity to work with the PI Industries Limited. It's again number two, number three company in India. So I work over there for 6 years as a marketing manager, senior marketing manager, and I switch after that DGM. I was covering entire Maharashtra state. So recently I joined Sulphur Mills Limited. So this is overall 14 years of my journey, and I think its journey will different from any other of experience, because my background was different. Nobody was not understanding what is the agriculture. Everybody knows the agriculture, everybody eating the agriculture produce and all, but nobody was known about the agriculture. 70% population indirectly depend upon agriculture. Okay, so that is again a story we'll discuss in after COVID situation and industry scenario. So that is overall 14 years of my journey, and I can really proud of my institute. I'll just give a couple of examples from last 4-5 years as I am working on senior management level. Every year 3-4 IIM candidates are coming from different IIMs under me for a project, summer internship and all. So I see the enthusiasm, I see the spark in them. I realize or I remember my days in MBA and all. So definitely the future managers, what we can say, opportunities are there. You have to look into that. Don't stick up with your domain. We have to expand your what we can say, the visibility around the world and all. So that is the thing which I just want to share with you. So thank you, sir.
Thank you. Now I would like to ask Rakesh sir about his journey. Yes, sir. Over to you.
Okay. Hello. Am I audible?
Okay.
Good afternoon, seniors and my classmate and my junior batch and new faces of 2021. I really welcome. But before going ahead, this is the IIBM customs, Riti Rivaj. We would like to have IIBM jingle. I'll say, give me I, you have to say I. I'll say, give me I, you have to say I. I'll say, give me E, you have to say E. Then I'll say, give me B, you have to say B. I'll say, give me M, you have to take a long M. It's like that. Hein? Then IIEBM. Okay, it'll be on three times it'll be. Okay, so I want to pump up with something, some energetic. I want to see your face. So, give me I, give me I, give me E, give me B, give me M, I, E, B, M. One more. Give me I, give me I, give me E, give me B, give me M, I, E, B, M. Thank you. So, I would like to talk about a transformational journey from campus to corporate. Okay, so I'll throw some points regarding the same. So these are fundamentally, both are different. Both are fundamentally different. Okay, I'll take some example. If you woke up late someday during the college life, so you might have a chance to miss a lecture, but you can join the another lecture. But in the corporate, you will have to be in time at the office every day. Okay, you need a reason, you need a motivation to which will wake you up every morning, which will wake you up. You will have to go through the same motivations. So you have to go through with the same scenario into the campus, corporate. So apart from that, there are many things in the corporate and in this life. What you need to, the biggest thing which you need to sacrifice, that is your comfort zone. Okay, you need to miss your friends' events, you need to miss your families, everything, hai na? Rona bhi aega. Hoga, aisa lagega ki yes yaar, what I'm doing here. Okay, but you need to feel that is the actual. In 2007, we were here. We used to have classes from starting from 7 o'clock. Hum aate the yahan pe 7 to 10, raat ko almost 10 baj jaate the, hai na? Omkar, if I'm not wrong. ओके दस साढ़े दस ऐसे बज जाते थे हमें. तो व्हाट वी लर्नड, हम चाहे क्लास में ऐसे बैठे हों, चाहे कुछ भी नहीं आ रहा समझ में, तो भी बैठे, पेशेंस, धैर्य सीखा हमने इससे. वी लर्नड पेशेंस. ओके, हमने धैर्य सीखा. वी लर्नड अकाउंटेबिलिटी फ्रॉम द कॉलेज. वी नो हाउ टू मैनेज आर एक्सपेंसेस. वी नो टू हाउ टू मैनेज आर रिलेशनशिप, हाउ टू को एग्जिस्ट विद द पीपल, जो आपके एसोसिएट हैं उनके साथ कैसे जाना है, कैसे रिलेशनशिप मैनेज करना, वो सीखा हमने यहाँ पे. We learned that. So we learned many things from the college, and it's a very big. So I'll take to I'll pass it to Omkar. He's from my batch. So meanwhile, I'll also share some points regarding the same.
Good afternoon. Sleepy. वो बंदा, अच्छा, ही इज नॉट विजिबल. आर यू ट्राइंग टू हाइड? ओके, सो टू स्टार्ट ऑन लाइटर नोट, आई विल टॉक अबाउट द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन, एंड यू कैन प्रॉबली टेल मी वेदर इट इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन और इट इज जस्ट अ एवरेज लाइफ ऑफ समवन. द फर्स्ट एवर मटेरियलिस्टिक ड्रीम विच आई हैड एवर सीन वॉज इन दिस कॉलेज. First week of our college, 2007-09 batch, and Jai sir came through his black safari. That time he used to drive black safari, and I spotted that car, and one thing came in my mind. Wow, pehli car leni hai to yehi leni hai. So this was my first materialistic dream, which was given by this college to me. Now coming to my journey, I'm proper from Kolhapur. Kolhapur, you might have heard about this district. It is 4 hours away from Pune. My life was just like a, you can say, happy-go-lucky person till my graduation, last year of my graduation. I did my BCom in Kolhapur, and I was all involved in playing tabla, doing dramas, I mean the Marathi theater, if you have heard of, in Kolhapur. Till second year I was very much involved in that. I had learned tabla for 12 odd years, and I passed almost 6 exams. I used to perform at Kolhapur Akashvani and everything. We used to perform fusion in our college, and I played state level intercollegiate drama competitions also. I got many awards there in Kolhapur. So life was like this. I mean, I was enjoying my stuff. I was never serious about my studies. 10th, I got 73 odd percentage, because that time parents are behind you to study and you have to study. 12th, I got 54% because I was all the way involved in only dramatics and tabla. In second year BCom, one magical thing happened in my life. I will be sharing this first time. I mean, Jai sir also is not aware about it. So one girl came in my life, who is my life partner now, in Kolhapur. So I was in love with her, and so our parents came to know about each other. So I sat down at home, and they told, we are okay if you get married with this girl, but for that you need to have job in your hand. Unless you have job in your hand, we'll not allow you to marry. I said okay. I took this casually. I mean, chalega, dekhte kya hona hai aage. Then my wife Sneha's parents came to know, and they called me at her place. And they said, we'll not allow this because you guys are not serious about your studies and we don't know what career you will make ahead. So I said, give me 1 month. I will decide what I want to do actually in my life and I will come back. So BCom ke degree se to job nahi lagegi, ya business to tha hi nahi ghar ka. Mere parents were in banking and I'm only child of my parents. तो मैंने सोचा कि क्या ऐसा मैं करूं कि जिससे मेरे को जॉब लग जाएगी जल्दी से. तो दैट टाइम MBA वॉज बूमिंग एंड आई डिसाइडेड लेट्स डू MBA बिकॉज इट रिजोनेट्स टू व्हाट आई लाइक. आई मीन आई नेवर हैड स्टेज फियर और आई नेवर हैड यू नो फियर इंटरेक्टिंग विद पीपल. आई एम ऑलवेज आउट गोइंग पर्सन. सो आई थॉट लेट्स ट्राई मार्केटिंग एंड बीइंग फ्रॉम फाइनेंस बैकग्राउंड फैमिली लेट्स ट्राई फाइनेंस एज ए स्ट्रीम. So I decided to do an MBA. I joined entrance class and our sir Ninad Yedurkar, who introduced me to this college, and I'm very fortunate that he introduced me to this college. So I registered for every odd entrance. Trust me, I had given CET, CAT, ZAT, NMAT, ATMA, everything. But as I was not good in studies and I was never, you know, I had never paid attention to studies. It was not like I'm not in good studies, but that time my interest areas were different. I was doing something else. So I got an average percentile in every exam which I gave. And I came to Ninad sir saying, sir, itna hi mila hai, kya karna hai? So he said ki, I will give you one really good college, which is not in top 10, but that college will give you what other top 10 colleges give. So I said, okay, I trust you. So Jay sir and Vinod sir came to our that entrance exam tuition class, and he interviewed me. So interview was not going that well. I was waiting for an interview and I was checking with my friends ki yaar andar shayad finance minister ko ne pucha hai, wo nahi rahe abhi finance minister. Ab andar RBI ka governor ke bare mein puch rahe, mere main bolunga finance kar raha hu aur wo main bolunga nahi aa raha hai to select nahi karenge, aur ye college haath se gaya to ye ladki bhi haath se chali ja sakti hai mere. I was dead serious about that interview, but I was not getting, you know, vibe of it. ये कैसे होगा ये? तो मैंने कोलेट की information and I sat and they interviewed me. और मेरे को एक पहले से ऐसी आदत थी कि अगर कुछ interview में नहीं आ रहा है तो try to deviate that interview where your interest area lies. And trust me, this works. So I got a feeling that Vinod sir listens classical music. So somewhere he asked, which classical musician you love the most? Then I said, I hear Bhimsen Joshi and Rajan Sajan Mishra the most and I love them. So he asked, have you heard Rashid Khan? Maine bola, nahi sir, nahi kabhi suna hai. So he said, why should we, you know, take in our college to do an MBA course? Then I said, only one thing, sir, I have never been, and he asked also that 73%, 54% and graduation 59% odd. So it clearly states that you are not, you know, focusing on your studies. So I said, sir, yes, but I was focusing on other areas and I was doing pretty well there. But now I want to be serious in studies. That's why I'm selecting your college. And I have gone through your brochure and my sir also told me that the college which thinks MBA is just not a classroom management teaching course, but it is a holistic course. And for that, this college provides hell lot of things that I will come to next point. And fortunately, I got selected. मैंने बोला ये तो निकल गया, अभी आगे जाके देखते हैं कैसे होता है. But I was pretty sure that I want to do this seriously and my wife also joined me in this college itself, that time only. So I went to their place that I got, I'm to tell, I got selected and let her join my college, that we are going to study only, we are not going to do any time pass, because ultimately you have told me ki job ka leke aao and get married. And first day I got a shocker that I am serious, I will do it. But 7:30 sharp, मेरा वहाँ पे टाइम टेबल था, मैं 11 बजे उठता था सुबह कोल्हापुर में, रात को ड्रामा की प्रैक्टिस 11 2 बजे तक आता था घर पे, सुबह उठता था 11 बजे, मैंने पापा को देखा नहीं था 6 महीने, क्योंकि वो सुबह जल्दी निकल जाते थे और जब मैं आता था वो सोते रहते थे. सो इट वॉज अ कम्प्लीट शॉकर टू मी, बट आई हैड डिसाइडेड दैट टाइम इफ आई नीड अ गुड जॉब आई विल हैव टू बी वेरी सीरियस अबाउट इट. सेकेंड शॉकर केम बीइंग फ्रॉम स्मॉल टाउन इन महाराष्ट्र. I had never spoken single statement in English fluently till that time. When I came in this college, I saw I have a content, I can communicate, but I cannot speak fluent English. And every alternate person around me was speaking in fluent English. So I said, let's crack this first. So like a hungry person, I used to read Economic Times in my hostel room loudly. Then I used to watch CNBC channel. I have not missed single opportunity to improve my English in first 3 months. And I collected some courage to speak up. So that journey, I won't call it as a transformation, but it started from there. And what this college has given to me cannot be replaced. I mean, whatever I am today is only because of this college. If you see our syllabus, I'm not talking about just our academical syllabus, that you will get it. But we got exposure. This college is all about exposure. You will get number of things to do here. We used to get yoga tuitions here. Then we got one outdoor OMT, we used to call outdoor management training. There, one of our batchmate made me leader of one particular group. So this college will constantly talk about for next year entrepreneurship, leadership, discipline, and holistic approach towards your life. In holistic approach, you will get fitness, you will have economic time session, which is the most important session one can ever have in MBA. Because when you read, RBI raises the repo rate. And when you read that news thoroughly, then you will understand the implication of that act on the industry that you won't get in textbook. So economic session you should never miss. That will give you the picture of industry. So you will get economic time session. Then sir took us to Rotary, one of social cause activity, wherein we gave polio drops to slum area kids. So at a face value you might feel ki isse management se kya sambandh hai, isse mera MBA karne se kya sambandh hai, but it's not like that. The number of things you are exposed to, you get to learn a lot. Jo khali yaha pe baith ke main aapko jo bhi bol raha hu usse nahi aapko milega, main kuch bhi padha hu aapko usse utna nahi milega, usse aapko khali upar ka surface scratch karne ko milega. Once you get into that water, and kaise aap jaoge us pe, to by trying different things. कि मैंने ये टच बेस किया है, इकोनॉमिक टाइम सेशन किया है, वी हैव बीन टू डिफरेंट स्टेट्स ऑल्सो टू प्रमोट अवर कॉलेज. सो दैट टाइम जय सर यूज टू आस्क अस कितना बजट है, ओके इतना बजट है, ले लो चेक ले लो. सो देयर यू गेट टू लर्न मनी मैनेजमेंट, हाउ टू टॉक विथ यूअर जूनियर्स, वॉट टू टॉक अबाउट योर कॉलेज. So I got to learn everything. Discipline was like, ऐसा था कि मेरे को एक बार
sir, Omkar sir, I would like to stop here.
Okay, sorry,
because
sir.
I would like to continue
no,
with
no
this
problem.
Because I know that you have a lot of feelings with campus.
Sorry for that.
No problem, sir.
Yeah.
So Devesh sir, now I would like to take a gender bias and I would like to start with Rajanandini ma'am. Please share your journey.
Thank you. See, for me, I so my journey, I would say, I have always been a very disciplined student since, you know, since my school. I come from a very strict family, to be very honest. Mine is a business family. My father is into business, and nobody in my family, being a girl, it was my first, you know, I was the one first person who came out of the family and started working outside. Okay, I was a serious student. I was studying, and I was very clear. I wanted to do something into technology, but I always knew that I will be the, you know, in future I'll be the one who's taking care of the entire management. Maybe I want to learn how to do a business, and you know, I knew that what I wanted to do. The only thing which I was lacking was an exposure. Okay, so if I talk about my transformation, it is totally about getting exposure. You know, right from the start, when you know I started looking for my summer internships, I knew I wanted to do something into marketing, and you know, along with that, I don't want to lose my touch into my technology. I got into digital marketing. Jay sir was kind enough to get me in touch with Mr. Santosh from FCB Ulka, and I started my internship from FCB Ulka, which is the third oldest agency in the world, I would say. I got wonderful, wonderful exposure over there. And that's when I started, you know, I got the idea that how the industry work. And trust me, when anybody in the college will tell you, ki go, you know, look something for yourself, just tell people what you want to do. You should be very clear. And I'm pretty much sure that people over here must not be very clear as of now. But listen to your professors. Maybe start reading is something very important. Maybe don't sleep in the sessions. I can see people sleeping here. So don't do that. And because, you know, once you start reading, that's one of the most important thing. Second, start listening to your professors. Third is be disciplined. Okay. That was also something, you know, I was lagging, but institute, you know, imbibe that quality also into me, and I'm still trying to. I can't say I'm perfect as of now, but I'm still trying to learn a lot of things. Economic sessions, just said, economics time session. So since, you know, I was clear, I wanted to do this, I wanted to do that, but finance was something I never could, you know, get a hack of, and I couldn't manage finance and the terms, etc. But when I came here, I started getting those jargons. Maybe I started getting what exactly happens just after I took my first class of economic times. I started understanding the terms, and that's very important. Since I wanted to get into marketing and digital marketing, etc., I started reading brand equity. That is again one one part of economic times which comes every Wednesday in your newspaper. You should start reading brand equity if you really want to get into branding or digital marketing. And apart from that exposure, as I already mentioned, the other thing which I really learned was networking. Just to give you an example, last year itself, unfortunately, you know, COVID hit all of us, and unfortunately I had to lose one of my jobs. I got a tremendous opportunity to really work with New Zealand embassy, just because, you know, I was in touch with Mr. Irfan Jafar. That too I got, yeah. And that too, I got the opportunity from the college itself, because there was one of the sessions, he was here and he was talking, and somehow he got to, you know, he connected me over LinkedIn, and he said that, look, I, you know, went through your profile, and I have this opportunity, and if you would like to, you know, work with us in the New Zealand embassy, nothing better than that. I mean, I would really want to see one of our alumni. Yes, yes. So one of our alumni to work with us, and you know, and over there I got the global exposure. Trust me, I was working with, you know, all the top level. I actually got a chance to work with the trade commissioner over there, Mr. Ralph Hayes. So, you know, that is sort of connection we used to get, and you know, you used to make when you start building up that community, or when you start actually putting in your efforts into all of these things. So, and you know, since as sir said, gender biasness, I am a woman, I would really want all of these ladies to come up and, you know, come with the greater ideas and be creative about, you don't have to worry about anything in the industries because people are, you know, literally smashing the glass ceiling. So, you know, so don't worry about it. I see a lot of girls not taking up opportunities because of course, so many things. They are not, but you know, you don't have to worry about anything. Yeah, you are, I guess, girls' power always. So, and I would like to ask you people if you are okay. I mean, do you have any questions, girls, boys, whatever? Please ask. Sure. Huh? That's what I feel. I mean, we really want to interact with them, right?
Yeah, am I audible? Yes, back there. Yeah. So first of all, thank you, Jai sir, and thank you entire IBM management team for giving me this opportunity to come over here and just to explain how we have. And I think I'm from batch of 2002-2004. That was too early. I was from third batch, if I'm not wrong. So we were at Chatushungi when I think we were 25 to 28 students that time, and I was pretty new to MBA because I am having a engineering background and that too mechanical. So as you can expect, mechanical engineers are typically focused a little bit disciplined, a little bit as in they are disciplined, but not to that extent to get into a scenario of an MBA student. So I had my experiences previously, like in mechanical engineering, there is a lot of challenges which we go to a lot of things. There are drawings. There are we burn a lot of midnight oil, you can say, and you know we always had that habit of waking up late and you know working too late in the midnight. So that habit we've always had. So and when we started, when I actually got an entry into MBA college, I was pretty new to the life, the complete lifestyle of MBA student, because it was like from morning 8 o'clock to evening 8 o'clock. And I was a little surprised with the kind of attitude everyone has. They are pretty focused, they're pretty determined. I was pretty new to the finance. I never had an interaction with any finance guy. I didn't know how to do debit, credit and all that. So those are the things that are very, very difficult for me. I think, as I said, I was very much disciplined, very much focused, and that has actually helped me a lot in terms of building up my entire career throughout 15 years of whatever experience I had. I think the most important thing which I learned here is that how you develop yourself as a person. As a person in the sense, the most important thing is that how you are going to build your leadership skill, because these are the only 2 years what you will get, and after that, once you get into a corporate world, it becomes very difficult to adjust. If you don't build your skills, if you don't build your the right mental attitude, if you don't build your you can say integrity also. So those are the things which are really important once you get into finance, once you get into corporate world, and the most important thing is that hard work. You know, people say that, you know, I can take a shortcut and probably I can, you know, get that solution. But I really don't want to get into that option, because, you know, hard work really pays off. Yes, you have to do little smart work, but yes, of course, the hard work you have to put in your hard work. And that's how you have to grow. Otherwise, it is going to be very difficult. Like others have mentioned already, Every day you have to develop some habit, a small habit, maybe a small step. You have to take a small steps by step. You can take and you can build that habit. And the another most important thing is that first I mentioned about the habit. Second thing is that integrity. In every corporate world, I think whenever if I'm also recruiting any person, the first thing I tell them that, or even if my superiors are interviewing or they are getting any person, the most important thing is that they say that I want a person who is the integrity is very important. So that is the second thing which is really, really important. And whenever you are taking any initiative, please start, you start taking initiatives in each and every section. Don't wait for someone to take initiative, you know, he will do a task for you. So don't wait for that. And, you know, changes are going to happen. So every day there are changes are going to happen. So you need to have that adaptability in yourself to make sure that, you know, you embrace that change so that, you know, you're not too much comfortable with certain environment. So that is really important. So the third thing which I learned here is that the time management, which I think most of them have spoken already. The time management is really critical. Once you lose that time, it is not going to come. So please make sure that in these 2 years, you have to build, see yourself 5 years down the line, what you want to become, and make your changes accordingly. So you want to become a certain person, you want to become an entrepreneur, what you need to do, what you need to change yourself, that you'll have to see. And then don't take, you know, a long jump, like, you know, I want to, tomorrow morning I have to wake up at 5 o'clock and I will start immediately. It will never happen. Start taking baby steps. You know, I'll wake up at 6:30, then start making at 6:15, then 6 o'clock. So, you know, you have to take steps like that. And then you build a habit, and then accordingly you can take the steps. So these are the certain things which I have learned here, and I'm proudly say that, you know, because of this I'm standing in front of you. So I also want you guys, you know, after 5 years, 6 years down the line, you guys also, I want, you are sitting here and, you know, giving your experiences to the new students. So actually, thank you so much, Jay sir, for whatever I am here, I am because of IIB only. I can proudly say that.
Thank you, Jay sir. Thank you, IIBM management team, for inviting me. First of all, I remember first thing which Jay sir used to say every time, that MBA is a orientation program, right? So that was his word. I think he is still using that word. So MBA is not a, you know, bookish thing, or what you guys are doing. It's not limited to the books, but it is going to give you a complete package. When I'm saying complete package, as most of us already said about that timeliness. We talk about the time management. We talk about the planning. We talk about the, you know, how you develop a habit for studying new things, right? So all those things which we have learned from IIBM is very important in our life, right? So I would like to give few examples which, you know, which actually helps me, and which helps me a lot. And when we were part of 2005 batch, so we have a e-commerce, e-business subject taught by Jay sir. So when Jay sir used to talk about all those dot-coms, Muchhad Panwala, etc., there are lot many examples he used to give. We used to laugh that, okay, these things are not possible, right? Now these things are possible. Everyone is having mobile, and everyone is more or less, this is, earlier it was a dot-com era, you must have heard about dot-com era, 90s. Now it's a startup era. And all the startups are dependent on e-commerce. Everything is dependent on e-commerce or e-business, right? So that gave me one perspective that, okay, how things works. And other things, the first job I got is with the help of Jay sir. He introduced me to MetLife, and I got selected. But at the same time, I've got a job at Syntel. So the first question they have asked, the interviewer asked, what is the Sensex today or yesterday? So there was my habit to read Economic Times. So fortunately, I read Economic Times because of Colonel Marwah's, you know, persuasion. I got to know, give the answer, and he was very happy. He said that I have taken interview of 10 to 12 guys, but you are the only one who is able to tell the answer. So whatever you study, it will never go in vain. It will definitely, you know, It will definitely help you somewhere, right? Second good example I will give you, that which, you know, again, because of Economic Times or because of sir's example, is the example of Dabbawalas, right? So sir gave us example of Dabbawalas, that how they are, you know, using Six Sigma and all, because their process is Six Sigma proof, more accurate than Six Sigma quality standard. So I have given an interview, that was my second job, and interview is in the quality quality department, and they were going to deploy Six Sigma, Kaizen, Kanban, all those stuff, right? So he told me that, do you know who has started Six Sigma? I have said yes. I know that Motorola has started Six Sigma. Motorola is one company which has started Six Sigma. Then he asked me to give me one example. So I gave him example of Dabbawalas, but fortunately he even don't know that a Dabbawala is, you know, using is Six Sigma sort of, they are having that kind of quality standard. Then he Googled and all, and then he came back me and offered me a job, right? So those things, those learnings will definitely come. And as most of us has told about the hard work and all, so I have failed so many interviews, right? So never ever fear that you will going to be failed, right? So every interview will give you some questions, right, which you are not able to answer, right? You have to learn, you have to find the answer for those questions and prepare for the next one, right? So that should be the approach. So that is one thing I would like to suggest. Second thing is discipline. So college taught me a lot of things which I were never, you know, worried about, from how to eat. Like, you know, there was our teacher, Vinita Chopra ma'am. I think most of us have learned that their personality development sessions, how you behave with, you know, it, the behaviors, etiquettes, you know, all these things valued a lot. So when you go to industry, so I'm not a chartered accountant, but there are chartered accountant who are, you know, just fresher out of chartered accountancy and they join the industry. But sometimes they lack few things, as I said, na, orientation program. They lack few basic etiquettes in the company, how to write emails or how to, you know, talk to people. So all those few things which you need to, you know, develops. And as we know that this is the era of pandemic, we are anyways going to discuss this as a part of next session. So we are lacking a lot of interaction with our teachers, our professors, but we need to learn those things by using YouTubes or any other electronic medium, because we have missed those medium when we were in our college time. Because in 2005-2007 there were no YouTube, there was less internet, and there is very less content available. Now whatever you want to learn, you can learn through internet, right? And one more thing I would like to emphasize, as he emphasized, about the communication skills. So when I came, I'm also from a very small town. There's a place called Katni in Madhya Pradesh. So I did my BCom there, and when I came here, so like his situation, my situation was the same. So I also flunked in this thing, interview. I don't know much, and Kanal Mava sir asked me, what is your habit? So what is your hobbies? So I've told him that I used to read a political magazine, India Today and all, and he asked me a few questions and I'm able to answer, then he selected me. So it was very easy that time, but later on there was a lot of struggle, right? Because when you are not able to speak with confidence, right? So then you might feel bad, right? But nowadays have been changed. You can learn a lot using digital media, right? So
I just wanted to add something. So as sir is you know, focusing and stressing upon how your personality or etiquettes should be, trust me, it matters a lot. When, you know, it makes you stand out of the crowd. It matters a lot when you are in the you know, in the corporate, or when you are actually at your workplaces. It makes you stand from the entire crowd, as he's saying, right? And all of us are, I mean, if I'm not wrong, they will be getting trained for all of the, you know, your email writing sessions, or maybe your corporate dressing sessions, or maybe all of these things. So, you know, I know you must be feeling ki are kuch kaam karne hoga, but trust me, that will be the one of the most important things you will be learning here, and it will help you out a lot, right? From writing your emails to, you know, eating on a table probably. So that's what I wanted to add up. You know, don't miss out on all of these classes also. At our time, Dr. or Mrs. Seshna used to come, and she was, you know, wonderful with her maybe the case studies, and you know how basically she used to teach us ethics, but you know, she used to help us out with the personality development and etiquettes also. So, you know, that's how we are the managers, and that's how we are, you know, are supposed to be, and that's what we'll be learning over here. So don't miss out on those sessions also.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much, Jay sir. Thank you so much, IIBM team, for inviting me here. Actually, it's in the last minute rush. I had come actually just to meet Jay sir casually, but I'm here, and it always feels very nostalgic. The stage was actually like second home for me. So 16-18 batch, earlier to that, I'll just give a background that I'm basically from Pune itself. So with my graduation, I had actually worked with a company named WNS. It's into global services. So with my graduation, it was almost like 3 years I worked with that company as an associate. It was just to get an idea of how the corporate world works. So somehow I managed my graduation times, and then WNS happened, and I really enjoyed my work there. It was basically understanding how to report to your manager, how to write emails. So it just was like a ground where I could explore myself. And then when I thought about growing myself to a managerial position, so that time MBA was compulsory. So whatever the internal job postings or like, you know, the requirement used to come, so MBA was a must. So I took a decision that I'll drop down, I'll like, you know, leave my job and I'll complete my MBA first. And that's when I came across MBA, IIBM, in this business school. And instantly I thought that, you know, this is the college I want to go, because I met Aarti ma'am that time during the interview, and the warm welcome I got from, I guess, the first on interview itself, I had lunch in the canteen. So that was the time I thought, you know, it was very welcoming, and I really enjoyed like, you know, the food here that time, and it was good. And in regards to the college, like, you know, when it started in July 2016, the first thing I had in my mind, like, you know, when I interacted with all the other batchmates, we were 180 students that time. So these were all freshers, and I was the only one who was like, you know, having some corporate experience of around 3 years. But I never got it into my mind. I thought that, you know, it's a new journey for me, and I'm here to learn. So I made myself like a white canvas. And trust me, guys, right from the first and the second day, I was involved into all the other activities that happens in the college. So whether it was the guys standing at the end of the auditorium, taking care of the discipline in the auditorium, like, you know, how to sit and how not to cross your legs when guests are there. I've managed that. I've also been a part of the name board team of, like, you know, managing, as the panels rightly said, about adhering to time. So when one guest finishes the lecture, the other guest is about to enter, and you have to make sure that the name board is placed. Apart from that, I've always also been in the escort team, like, you know, going and bringing the guest, because I was a localite, so I knew the places. So I never missed any.
I can say that because of hurrying into the getting the placement. That time PPO was there, pre-placement offer was there. So before you were finishing 1.5 year, everybody was want to enter into the corporate. Nobody was, basic idea were not there in our mind, like how we are going to deliver our output in a corporate. Everybody want to enter into the corporate life very earlier. So my summation in on this point is, don't get hurry for the placement. To your question, I can add one thing. First, complete your 2 year session. We are spending huge amount of money. Okay, so take a output of this money. Each and every penny is very important. Whatever we are getting from this institute, it's really, really important. And one thing I just want to share here. When I entered into the Mahiko Rally, Syngenta, there were people from Symbiosis background, I am Ahmedabad background, I am whatever top B school, you can take an example. There were people sitting into the corporate office at higher level of our, because we are sitting into the field level. Okay, but they didn't know the basic things. Why? Because they are recruiting from the higher B schools. They don't know how to act with the people, how to manage the people, how to interact with the people. They don't know about the farmer mentality, farmer perception, farmer's requirement. They only know about the analytics. Okay, Excel they don't know, they know very well. We want these kind of people who are sitting into the, who are traveling into the field, who are getting into knowledge from the people and farmer and all these things. So basically my suggestion or my advice to each one of you, that grow step by step, take maximum output or maximum knowledge from the institute, try to complete 2 years in the institute. After that, whole what we can say, the whole life is yours for earning money. I'll just share one incident just happened, Jay sir, with me. I got an opportunity for applying the entrance examination for PhD in management studies. Because one of my friend who was working with the corporate, he told me that you are good at your domain, you are good at your leadership and all. So why don't you join this management PhD program? So I just clear my management PhD entrance test. So maybe next time when I will come, I will welcome doctor. Okay.
Yes, next question to students. Yes.
Good afternoon to all the panelists and everyone present over here. So we are learning so many things from day one over here, and we are literally very happy for being a member of this college as we are listening from you all. So I would like to ask something. Integrity is something which we have inside, imbibed within us from very childhood, and it keeps on growing. But at a certain point, when we start our career, something we find that it's getting lost because of something, office politics, culture, and something. So what is the thing when leadership comes into existence? How can we manage that?
Yes.
Okay. I'll say in the corporate, keep stay away from the internal politics. Okay, whatever in case you did some mistakes or something is someone is trying to that mistake done by someone else, and in case you want to say yes, I'm responsible for this one, so it build a confidence in the management. Okay, but whatever in you might be some prankster in the college, you might be involving with lots of friends, your assignment is done by your friends, your classmates, maybe it might this is the reality I'm telling you. Okay, but in the corporate it never happened. You are the junior most. Nobody will treat you like that ki nobody will say you did great. Like in the college, you know what is the output. Either you will get grade A, grade B, but you know there is a pattern, there is a discipline. But in the corporate, it is entirely different. Okay, so you have to stay, you have to away from these internal politics, these WhatsApp gossips. Okay, people will find out you. Your boss, they know that they have the third eyes. They know what you gonna to do. It is real. It is in reality. I am telling you, this is very, very, very true. Okay, कुछ mistake हो जाती, गलतियाँ हो जाती. Accept करो. मैंने किया है. I did this, sir. I am responsible. I'll make it correct. Okay. So this I want. Anyone would like to add this?
Yeah. Let me add some. So when we call integrity and politics, they are two different things, right? When we say integrity, it is, you know, beyond honesty, right? So there are instances happens in corporate when someone get fired because they are submitting false bills, false medical bills. So that is again, you know, that is called an integrity issue, right? And office politics is nothing to do with the integrity. You are not cheating anything. You are not cheating your bosses. You are not cheating the company, right? So that is how we can, you know, call out integrity. So there is a very thin line between, you can say, politics or integrity, but be accountable, as he said, and be responsible for your mistakes. So that we can, you know, pronounce as integrity.
Yeah. I just want to add to integrity. I think the integrity, you know, it should come from your heart. Yeah, because you need to be very, very honest to if you're working in a corporate, they are paying you, so you need to be very honest to the company. So I think if you're honest to the company, I think the integrity issue will not be there anywhere.
So as he rightly said, that's what I wanted to add. It is something which comes from within, right? So whenever you're gonna, of course, there will be instances in your life wherein you will have to make a decision and you will be responsible for that. So there will always be two part of it, right? Wherein your internal conscience will tell you ki if you do this, will it harm your integrity, or, you know, is it correct? Within, you'll have to question yourself. And you'll get the answer. It is something which is your principle or values which have been imbibed into you, right? So nobody can actually answer this question, how to handle your own integrity, right? It's something which comes from within. And at that point of time when the question arises, when you have to decide whether this is right or wrong, it is one, you yourself have to decide that, you know, the integrity is there or not. That's you yourself have to decide. Nobody can answer that question as of now, I believe.
And just to add up, see, integrity ko compromise karke, you will get only short-term benefits. Just mark this in your mind very clearly that people who compromise their integrity, they might get good results, but in short term, in long run, it never happens. It is going to be costly for them. Just to quote two examples to add. When I was working, today I am an entrepreneur, but earlier I worked with HDFC in Kotak. Whenever I used to switch my bank, I was in sales. I used to go to my client and tell, sir, I'm switching my bank. Don't change your bank account to me. Because I am going there, I will not come to you that I am going to this bank and come there. If you feel any problem with your account in existing bank, then only call me up. This is integrity. Because if I keep on switching four banks and if I keep on going, this is a common practice people do. They go to client, they ask, sir, main aaj ye bank mein gaya hu, yahan pe relationship khulwao. To client bhi sochta hai ek time ke baad ki this guy is hopping. And for him, should I change my bank account? Because he is connected with a lot of suppliers. This is one example. Second, to quickly add, my boss was telling me once that you map your teammates' account to you and get your target completed. Because I was falling short of some amount in foreign exchange. So I said, sir, appraisal kam hua, tabhi bhi chalega. But I won't do this mistake because it is not good. This is one of examples of integrity. And when I quit my job, my every boss visits my place, my office, and tells that we are working with you. And so this was, I was able to do, or they are coming to me because they know how I am. If I was like fudgy all the time, doing everything for short-term benefits, compromising my integrity, then it would have never happened.
I just want to add integrity and office politics. Integrity, I'm working in hardcore sales and marketing, and I am at the people manager's role. So basically, I'm dealing with 110 people from entire Maharashtra state. So these people are directly reporting to me. When integrity comes, if I'm sitting in a Pune and I just want to monitoring my each and every person who are sitting into the different places of the Maharashtra, how I come to know that ki these people are doing or not? Or these are people are traveling or not. So technology has given us a very good tool. Everybody is having a own app. I am sitting in right now in IBM. I can know that where Nagpur person is sitting where, or he is traveling where. That is one part. So integrity, that is right now digitalization has been changed all the integral part of things. Nobody has don't want to submit a manual report or something like that. Everybody is having digital kind of things. So number one. Number two, office politics is everywhere, I can say. Everywhere. If you are sitting in head office, if you are sitting in a field, or when you are dealing with the people, there is the politics. When you are dealing with the people, there is a politics. Because everybody is having their own mindset, their own, what you can say, thoughts, and everybody want to express their thoughts on other side. Okay, everybody wants. So our job is like that. Suppose I am having 110 people and I want to say hello for each and every team member. It will take around 2 to 3 hours daily. I am not talking with each and all kind of you. Okay. So when you are dealing with the people, you have to be focused. You have to be focused. Like why I am calling him? What is my motive? That will be learned after you enter into the corporate. That is another thing. But yes, there are the people who are interesting to do the office politics. But we have to isolate from this. If you enter into the politics, then we will be the part of this office politics. That is the suggestion.
Learning how to tackle all these things.
Yes, next question. Yes, please.
Good afternoon to the panel. As the panel pointed out that there's an obvious difference between campus and corporate life. So what do you think the, you know, threat to us freshers is. The threat to us freshers when we enter the corporate life. Because when it comes to our batch, we have a wider gap in knowledge when it comes to conceptual and practical learning because of COVID. So what is the threat that we face when we enter the corporate life?
I think just to add to the previous question, what he has mentioned, see, there is no threat as such. I mean, you might be perceiving as it, you know, it is a threat, but it is not a threat. But you know, whatever learnings you are going to get from here, that is what going to you have to impart it over there. So, so at this point of time, your focus should be on what you're going to learn and what you're going to, you know, change yourself in the next 2 years. So that is very important, rather than thinking about what will happen after 2 years. Because these are the things, you know, after 5 years, these are the things which were, you know, continuously running in our mind. These are some of the anxieties, you know, we can say that. So this is some, so there is nothing to scare about it. You just need to learn whatever this institute is giving it to you. You just need to learn. You need to just absorb everything, what you are getting from here. And once you do that, you have to make sure that, you know, you do a lot of hard work in terms of learning new things. That is very important. So once you do that, and with the practice sessions, like for example, mock sessions, mock interview sessions, the case studies, how you're going to handle case studies, how you're going to learn different things, what you were doing earlier, what you have changed yourself. I'll give you some of the examples. My boss used to say, three things, don't assume. Second thing, never say never. And the third most important thing is that if you do same thing what you're doing right now, you'll get the same thing what you're getting it. The results are going to be same, so you have to change every time. If you want to make a better result, you have to change. You have to modulate. You have to see what you're going to change yourself. And then that's how you're going to change. So don't think about what is going to happen after 2 years when I'll join corporate. So nothing, you just need to trust the process, whatever you're going through. This 1.5 years or 2 years of your career, with this institute. So that is what all it's going to, you know, make it a kind of success story for you.
So there are two things I wanted to tell you. See, first of all, for example, if let's assume this is the ladder, okay, your career entirely is a ladder of maybe 50 steps, okay? So try and understand, this is your first step wherein you are learning everything. This is your first step. You have to take this first step in the faith, right? Because you are learning, you are at a right place and you're learning everything. Second, what I could sense out of your question is that you are probably very anxious about the current scenario, wherein you mentioned that there might be a gap between a practical learning and maybe the entire online digital world, which is right now going on. You'll have to try and understand this is actually an opportunity for you, because henceforth the world will be 90% digital. You'll have to understand this. Why don't you try and take it as an opportunity? You could be the flag bearer of this entire maybe a paradigm shift which is happening right now. The batches which, you know, for say the COVID batches or, you know, whatever. You guys might be, you never know the future. Yeah, you guys could be the flag bearer of this entire paradigm shift or the entire, you know, evolution which is going to take place now. So this is an opportunity for you, I believe, and you will definitely discuss in the next session about how the things are transforming and, you know, what is the changes, what are the changes which are happening in the industry right now. But don't worry about it, because this is the new you are going to, you know, maybe seize in next few months probably. Okay.
So when you talk about threat, and I would just like to say that actually the threat is not for you, but for the people who are already sitting in the corporate. Because I'll tell you, people who are already holding some positions, they have become very lethargic. They know the process. But if at all you really enter with your own knowledge or self-learning that you do, and you can be, as he rightly said, flag bearer or something, or as we call it, carpet bombing, of getting into something or showing the company that this could be done in a very different way and this could save your time or money and a lot of things. That would be your innovation. But I'm really telling you that will be a threat for the people who maybe you will be reporting to or your colleagues there. Because I have seen in this last 3-4 years that there are juniors who are getting promoted, not the people who are vintage. Because vintage people, they think that, okay, I will get that importance. Company owes me something. But in corporate world, vintage has no value. Only the productive people, the people who are on toes and they're getting something to the company, only they would value for them. So I think that should be the right thing.
See, the day you will enter in corporate, now for first 3 to 6 months, what will happen to you, I will just tell you. You will not understand the processes. So you need to be, you know, quick learner and be persistent about learning. You need to ask your boss and colleagues, teach me. If you be like let go attitude or let back attitude, nobody is going to handhold you. So first 3 to 6 months, don't take it as threat. Work more, learn more, spend more time in office, understand things. This is first scenario. Second scenario, and if you are smarter than your boss, and if your boss realizes that, and if he is a bad boss, a short tip to you, loop in your boss's boss, two levels up, they should know what you are doing in office. That's all.
Thank you, Omkar sir. And Akash sir, thank you very much. You have boosted the confidence of student that it's a threat to the corporate, not to the students. Yes, so next question.
Good evening, my name is Poonam Vagmare and I hail from Pune, Maharashtra. My question is a bit long, so kindly bear with me. So as like sir earlier mentioned that one of his teachers suggested that I'll name an institute which is not in the top 10 but will give you knowledge equivalent to those top 10 institutes. So my question to all of you, and especially Akash sir, because he's one of the recent pass outs. So what changes you made at your end to, you know, compete with those candidates who will be coming from those top 10 institutes, and how this college helped you to compete with them and get an edge over them?
Okay. So you're talking about the competition that we would face from the other B schools?
Yes, sir. The top 10 B schools.
Okay. I would just answer this question with one example. So sir will remember there was a job opening at Amazon. So that happened at PIBM College. And we were around 25 people who were selected for that. And the package was really lucrative. That was around 13 lakhs package. That was Amazon. That's it quoted at 13 lakhs. Later on, we got to know the reality was different. So we went there at PIBM College, and they have a huge auditorium. And when we entered there, we got to know that there were at least 1,000 plus students who were from different B schools, from Kirloskar, from the nearby college, Sai Balaji, Indira, and all that stuff. I would just like to tell you that, you know, one difference that even the panelists, they could really make it out there, was the difference of how we, IIBMites, were different in our dressing style, the way we were poised, the way we sat there. Even during that long lectures, we started that journey around 8 o'clock in the morning, and I was one of the last people there, maybe selected. I was in the top 4 or 5, and my interview, the last interview, was around 11:30, 11:45 night. But still, we had the patience of sitting, just like the people are sitting now. So that was our test time, and we really did well. And not even I got selected there, and no one got selected. But I would like to say that we really stood out. We were around in the top 6. We were on 2 from IIBM. But the other people, they didn't have proper haircuts for the boys, and for the girls, they didn't know what footwear to wear when they were into the interview and how to be poised. And a lot of things matter. And I would say that even in the group discussion, because we had a lot of sessions where mock interviews were taken, and I guess Poonam ma'am was there, so we really were good at it. Even in the group discussions, I could make sure that, you know, our batchmates, they were really killing it in the interview. So that was a difference. Other people, they were only about how to get this time out. We got a day out of the college. But trust me, our batchmates that time, the kind of atmosphere we got in the college, we were really focused that we have to crack this. Because everyone wanted that, a poster I've got the biggest package or something like that. Everyone wanted. We really did well. But the result was something else. But we stood out. That was a difference we could make in that 1,000 plus batch. So hope you got the answer.
Yeah.
See, I never mentioned this ever over here, and probably Jayasa also didn't know this. Do you know IBS Mumbai? You know, right? I studied there for 6 months. And after that, I came to this college. Trust me, those 6 months were the most lost months of my life. I didn't know what to do. Nobody was focused, because the batches over there were like in 6 sections. Okay? Nobody knew I existed there. I was one of those passionate students, but I was lost. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what am I studying. I didn't know my syllabus, I didn't know nothing. So this is my first-hand experience. When you talk about, you know, getting that edge, I think you're going to get it, because this is my personal experience. You are looking at me right now, sitting over here, talking to you very confidently. I was lost for 6 months. So, you know, I don't want to talk about all of these top institutes and all, what do they do? I don't know, I really don't know. But the end product is in front of you, okay? I was there for 6 months. For some reasons, I didn't want to continue. But right now, I'm here talking to you, and I guess, it's, you know, that answers your questions very well. So don't worry about an eyewear of your customer, okay? For example, if you're selling off the shoes online, you should know what keywords your customers might type on the search platform, and then that's how we're tapping him and, you know, getting the customer to be converted on your website. It has nothing to do with your technology, coding part of it, okay? So, I mean, what I feel, if you are if you did your graduation into economics, wonderful, you know how to crunch the numbers, and I don't think you'll be facing any problem if you go ahead with any of these courses, okay? Thanks.
Thank you, ma'am.
One more line.
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
So, for any, as ma'am highlighted, for any tool, you know, there are the public who is, you know, preparing the tool, right, building the tool, and there are the end users, right. So, not necessary you are building the tool, but you can fall into the place of end users. So, if you know that how to operate that tool, that is also a beneficial thing, because ultimately some of the users require to, you know, that to run the tool. So there is always a scope if you know it, if you know the technology.
Thank you, sir.
So, yes, last question, if anyone have any question.
Good evening, one and all present over here. My name is Komal Tiwari and I am from Jabalpur, Madhya Pradesh. So my question is, when you were at your college days and there was placement, I guess. So how did some of you fail or rejected as well, I think. So how did you all cope with that scenario and those failures?
Yes.
So, we have started interviewing, I guess, after third semester, some of us, right? There are many companies which we, you know, which we have got an opportunity to give an interview. So we know that, okay, if we are getting failed, this one college will provide this, or we will find another one. So we always have had this positive attitude towards us, and every failure, and I can say that every failure will give you perspective to think that why did you get failed? What is that lacking in you, or in your profile or in your CV? What went well or what went well? So you have an opportunity to analyze yourself. Okay, you can evaluate that what went well or what did not go well according to you, right? So never ever think that failure will always be there. You know, I'll tell you. A simple example, sometimes, you know, failure leads you to the bigger successful platform. There are many instances, right? I don't want to name the company. It was a staffing company. I got failed there. They have not hired me, right? But now I'm working with a 100 times bigger company, right? So sometimes don't think that you can think that God has better plan than this. So always be positive.
One more thing is, it is okay to fail, okay? understand the mistake which you have done, don't repeat the mistake. Learn from that mistake. Next time do new mistake, but don't repeat the mistake. And secondly, even if you fail, see, there are chances. There is one type of ego which is a bad ego and one is good ego. Take it on your good ego. इसमें मैं फेल कैसे होगी, आई विल डू इट, इस पर इम्प्रूव करके इस पर ही मैं इंटरव्यू निकालूंगी. सो टेक इट इन अ गुड वे, डोंट टेक इट इन अ बैड वे. बहुत लोगों को लगता है यार फेल हो गया तो अभी सब खत्म. इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. यू विल हैव थ्री मोर अपॉर्चुनिटीज, मे बी नेक्स्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी विल बी बेटर देन अर्लियर वन. सो गो फॉर इट, गो फॉर इट.
सो हम लोगों के यहाँ पे एक लोकल लैंग्वेज में एक यू नो देयर इज दिस फ्रेज व्हिच इज कॉल्ड, अगर ओखली में माथा दिया है तो धमके से डरने की जरूरत नहीं है. ओके, सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, आई थिंक फेलियर, आई रियली फील फेलियर इज अ ब्लेसिंग इन डिस्गाइज. ओके, यू फेल एंड आई रियली फील वंस यू फेल यू ग्रो, यू नो यू गेन दैट स्ट्रेंथ अगेन. तो जितना फेल होगे आप उतना ज़्यादा स्ट्रांग होते जाओगे, तो जितना धमका खाओगे उतना ज़्यादा स्ट्रांग होगे. सो डोंट वरी अबाउट फेलियर्स.
थैंक यू एवरी वन फॉर योर वैल्यूएबल इनपुट्स एंड आई अप्रिशिएट ऑल स्टूडेंट्स पेशेंस एंड आई नो दैट इफ वी विल गिव टाइम टू ऑल द अलुमनाई दे विल गेट नॉस्टैल्जिक एंड दे विल शेयर देयर व्यूज कंटिन्यूसली. सो आई वुड लाइक टू ब्रेक ओवर हियर. ओके, so first of all, okay, before I would like to conclude, I will say some shayari for all of you. Okay, is it fine, sir? Yeah. Okay, so gami hasrate nakam se jal jate hai, it is not written over here. Gami hasrate nakam se jal jate hai, hum charago ki tarah sham se jal jate hai. Gami hasrate nakam se jal jate hai, hum charago ki tarah sham se jal jate hai. शमा जलती है जिस आग में नुमाइश के लिए, हम उसी आग में गुमनाम से जल जाते हैं. जब भी आता है आप सभी का नाम IIBM के नाम के साथ, जब भी आता है आप सभी का नाम IIBM के नाम के साथ, जाने क्यों लोग IIBM के नाम से जल जाते हैं, जाने क्यों लोग IIBM के नाम से जल जाते हैं. थैंक यू वेरी मच. सो थैंक यू एवरी वन फॉर कवरिंग ऑल द थिंग्स. Special thanks to Rakesh sir for giving us a fabulous story about the journey when he was traveling and he told the third person that I will lose my job if you will not tear this letter. Okay, so really it's a presence of mind you have used which our student will use for the good purpose whenever it is required. As well as Praveen sir, thank you for sharing one most important thought that all the farmers are using video calls today to discuss the things they are facing. So really it's a good thing for us that all our farmers are using smartphone, means technology reached till the root level and we are using that. So India is growing and we have a lot of opportunities in all the fields. So thank you sir, thank you for that. Thank you Akash for giving, means enlightening the students about the time management and how you have grown yourself in so short time period with the help of IIBM. And Jubair sir, thank you very much to being a mechanical engineer. You are doing MBA and right now you are working as an area sales manager. So it will help our student to know that anyone can do anything. Rajnandini ma'am, thank you very much for, first of all, thank you for giving us a time because I know that you have some other work but still you have managed time for IIBM and come here and you have shared your views. As well as thank you Omkar sir for your entrepreneurial journey you have shared in short period of time, how you have switched your job and how you have started with the Acutus investment. Then the, okay, I think I have, sorry. Devesh sir, thank you very much for sharing your view. Especially you work with the, means I have one Kapil Sharma type of question in my mind. Why you work with only the multinational companies, not with the startups? As you have a knowledge, you can grow them. So thank you sir, sharing your view about how you got selected with the multinational companies and how, means which skill sets are required for all the students to means how to enter in these type of companies. So with this small note, I would like to conclude our session over here. Okay, thank you very much. One thing. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So as I missed this, extremely very sorry, sir. So as everyone have mentioned this, it was in my mind that I would give mic to Jay sir, because everyone have mentioned that. Everyone said that, means whenever he shared his journey, Jay sir was somewhere. Means whether about the learning, about the teaching, somewhere Jay sir was there. So I would like to give this mic to Jay sir to share his view on this.
Take much time, tortured them adequately for their journey over here. So I don't, want to take much time. Then, it's always a matter of great pride when they who are sitting on this side were at that side, and now they're representing the institute on this side. So that's the biggest pride for me, because many a corporates come to this institution. But the biggest pride is when you have your own corporates coming back to you, who are your alumni, and who are sharing their success stories or their life journeys with the batches to enter the corporate world. So, and as some of them did mention to you, eventually it's a network of network. So if you connect with each other, you don't know. I was surprised when she said Irfan Jafar from the first batch. So he helped her. So how you connect with people, how your connections grow. And I told you one thing, your network is your net worth. Your network is good, your net worth is solid. Because eventually, whether it's business, whether it's contracts, whether it's whatever you do, your network is defined or not, your network will define where you're going to be. And your contacts are your contracts. Umkar may agree or disagree, or he may agree to disagree. But then your contacts are your contracts. So that's the way things happen. And in this now economy, which is so connected on LinkedIn, Facebook, and different social and professional, networking platforms, you've got a great resource. And the way they all are doing, the way the other alumni are doing, you all are a very powerful fraternity. It's again for you to accept how powerful you are and have a superiority complex, or you to feel you've got an inferiority complex. As they also said, be where you are, understand the process, go through the process, and end result will be good. But then you have to have faith in yourself, to faith on your capabilities, on your institution, processes. They are there to help you. The alumni will definitely help all of you. In fact, they've been helping. Today only we got a selection from 99 Acres, where Akash was working. A lot of selections are coming, again, because of companies where the alumni have performed exceedingly well. So alumni performance results in a benefit for all of you also. Because those companies, when I speak to the HR, I say, madam, this boy or that, I have to take names of the student. They say, yes, IIBM. So, Asian Paints, for an example, now they're known by the alumni. Because Asian, the days they start recruiting from here, the performance of our alumni has been so good that the HR recognizes the college by the name of the alumni. So, that's the strength you all have. You're in good hands. They're great people. So, thank you so much. And I said, it feels so good, to see the transformation happening from there to here. That's the biggest pride for anyone.
Exactly. So I was just noticing Jay sir, and the way he take pride in all of his students is wonderful. I really like that. And it is for everybody. I mean, when sir was talking and I could see in his eyes, the pride I could feel was amazing. So, that gives the other level of energy, or maybe the next level of happiness sometimes. So,
Go for a OMT with him.
Yes.
The next marathon.